You guys, thanks for coming back at the last story of the day on 20 Minutes or Less. I'm Joe Beretta.
I'm Lee Newton.
Oh, here we go. PlayStation Vita came out yesterday and it was released to mixed reactions. And that's not because it isn't an amazing device, because it is. It combines PS3 graphics with a 5-inch LCD screen, is 3G compatible, rocks both a front and back touchscreen, supports both card-based and downloadable versions of games, has dual analog sticks, and is incredibly light and super sleek. Then that would be you.
Oh, yeah, okay. There's an inherent social gaming aspect to the Vita as well. You'll be able to utilize your PlayStation Network idea with the Vita.
This is really distracting.
Programs like Near will allow you to locate other gamers in your vicinity, check out their gaming habits, and friend them up. You'll also be able to browse the online shop. You'll be able to download the first-party Sony published games and other TV shows and movies. Netflix is also an option, and the Vita can run multiple apps, so it's super convenient for gamers.
However, there are some drawbacks with the Vita. Some criticisms have been that it's not backwards compatible with the physical versions of the PSP games.
The battery is internal and has a short life.
The cheapest version of the Vita is also $100 more than the DSi.
And the launch titles are not the strongest, even though FIFA, Ninja Gaiden, and Uncharted are among them.
A lot of reviewers are claiming that this is the most powerful slash most capable gaming device ever made. So then it makes you wonder, why isn't everybody grabbing their $250 to $300 and going out and grabbing this thing?
Oh, I just learned something!
Good job! See, it is an amazing piece of gaming machinery, so I don't think the problem resides in the Vita itself. I just think the world of portable gaming has migrated a bit. Now when people are commuting, they're playing Angry Birds on their iPads and iPhones and stuff. Because of this, the need for another handheld gaming device is kind of lost on the general public, which Sony should understand because of their experience and lackluster sales with the Xperia, which was their PSP slash weird phone thingy. And then it's you again.
Oh, okay. Phones seem to have an advantage anyways, because everyone already has them and games range from free to 99 cents. Oh, but then they get you because you drop 20 bucks into all those extras like Infinity Blade and Temple Run.
But don't feel too bad for Sony. It's estimated that the Vita sales will bring in $2.2 billion worth of revenue for Sony Corp. If people in the States don't want to drop 300 bucks, just sit back for a little bit. It's estimated that the prices will go down to around $180 later in the year.
So what do you guys think? Are you going to pick up the new PS Vita? Why or why not?
You're just terrible at this.
Or are you gonna keep playing games on your smartphones and ThinkPads and stuff? Let us know in the comments down below.
Don't forget to click the like and subscribe button, click the annotation down below, or go to sourcefed.com for 5 daily stories and everything else we've ever done. I'm Lee Newton.
I'm Joe Beretta.
Phil.
Bye, Phil.